again, I think there's a perception of that. A lot of agents, a lot of appraisers, and a lot of sellers seem to think in gross numbers and not net numbers. And those two numbers are drastically different. When an agent says that they can list a house, they're talking gross numbers. When an appraiser says your house is worth X number of dollars, they're talking gross numbers. But quite frankly, that is not realistically what a person will net if they want to sell a house. If they don't care about selling a house, it doesn't matter. But if they want to sell a house, they have to think in net numbers and about realistic net numbers. And so when a person sells a house, there's always the typical transaction costs that go into selling a house. There's always a marketing cost, whether a person uses an agent or not. They have to find a buyer. There's the transaction cost of a closing agent or closing company, title insurance, the title closing fee, the pest inspection, the recording fees at the courthouse. And some states are more or less than other states. And there is the reality that typically a buyer will not pay asking price. They always want a deal. I'm sure when people bought their house, they wanted a deal. And most buyers, especially first-time home buyers, will get a government-backed loan, an FHA or VA loan. And although a seller doesn't have to pay their closing costs, most of the time a buyer will always want a seller to pay for those closing costs. And that's all negotiable, but again, that all plays a role into the transaction cost. And so what I found is that most times a seller will only net 80 to 90% of the at best of whatever that gross sales price is. And a lot of sellers don't realize this until they're at the closing table looking at the numbers, and by then it's too late to turn back typically. So a lot of it is education of what the reality is of selling a house.